What comes is better than what came before.
The holographic idea says that the future is always present, is always enfolded in the whole, just as this, as there's an unbroken wholeness amongst all things, all objects in the universe. We don't realize how much we can affect the world just through our attitudes and through what we believe. That's one of the most exciting things about the holographic idea. If reality is holographic, you're helping create it by believing it. That if we learn how to tap this power through belief and profound faith, when we do that, we'll be able to change our bodies in ways that seem miraculous. And it's clear that we do this on an unconscious level, because I think we have all these abilities, we just don't realize we have them, and so they're unconscious in ourselves. You know, we've got to stop being infants at the control panel, that we've got to learn what all those switches and all those amazing mechanisms are for, and how to do them, how to use them. I don't believe the future is frozen in stone, but what I do believe is that the future is coalescing to a certain degree, just as, I mean, there's an unbroken wholeness between the past and the future and the present. That if we knew how to sort of tilt the hologram of the universe or the hologram of reality like it's a gem, we could tilt it at different angles and see different aspects of time in each of its different facets. We seem to be tapping into four main probabilities, four different possible futures for the human race. And when people access the future, what they're doing is seeing probabilities. They're seeing what's more likely to happen, what is starting to coalesce. Because another thing that the holographic idea suggests is that there isn't necessarily just one reality, that they're all different levels of reality. Some of them were kind of apocalyptic, where pollution overran everything. Some were sort of new age in a kind of simplistic way, and some were more meaty and positive futures in a meatier way. And it's interesting because it seems to reflect our beliefs about what the future are, our understanding of what the possibilities are. So this is important in two ways, because number one, it means we should be very careful about what we believe about the future. We should also realize that the future can be better than what we can currently conceptualize. If reality is holographic, you're helping create it by believing it.
For oneself, what one does is draw a circle and then think of the different impulse systems in your life, the different value systems in your life, and try then to compose them and find what a center is. It's a kind of discipline for pulling all those scattered aspects of your life together, finding a center and ordering yourself to it. So you're trying to coordinate your circle with the universal circle. The Navajo have that wonderful image of what they call the pollen path. And when you realize what pollen is, it's the life source. And it's a single path to center. And then they will say, you know, beauty before me, beauty behind me, beauty to the right of me, beauty to the left of me, beauty above me, beauty below me. I'm on the pollen.
Here's my point, folks. In the blink of an eye, we can have heaven on earth. It's a choice. It's all it is. There's no evolution. No need to go any farther. We know it now. It's all here. It's all there. It's all right now. It's a choice. You can look through the eyes of fear. You can look through the eyes of love. It's the only two ways to look. The eyes of fear is insanity. It's not really there. The eyes of love, the only real ones are being, go. Being, fucking, go. Heaven on earth right now. It's a choice. Look through the eyes of love instead of the eyes of fear, just once. Like, for instance, the money we spend on weapons and defense each year, the money we spend on buying bigger locks and more fucking cops, instead if we spent that money feeding, clothing, and educating the poor of the world, which it would pay for many times over, not one human being excluded, because one race, explore outer space together, in peace, forever.